Dear students, welcome back to the English class. I hope whatever we did in video tutorial part 1 is clear to all of you. Now before I commenced with the further chapter, let us have a brief recap of where we had left. What we saw earlier was that the author's idea is that if people can be taught hatred, they can also be taught love and brotherhood. In their most testing times in prison, when they were being treated brutally, Mandela would see a pinch of humanity and kindness in one of the guards, and that was enough to keep him going. He believes that goodness in human beings can be suppressed, but it can never be eliminated. So students, now let us start with the last paragraph of this page. In life, every man has twin obligations. Obligations to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children. And he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country. In a civil and humane society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations and abilities. Inclinations here means natural tendencies of behavior. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his pupil was inevitably ripped from his family. Ripped means taken away. That is badly torn from his family. And his home was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family. But in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, as a brother, as a father, and as a husband. So now here we see that according to the author, he says that every human being has responsibilities towards his family. But there are some responsibilities which we have as well as to the society. Generally, under normal circumstances, a person can maintain the balance between the two. Between the two means his duties towards his family and his duties towards the society. A man can very easily maintain the balance between the two if it is any other country. But in countries like South Africa, it was not so easy. When a person of color would come up for his society, he would be arrested and taken away from his family, thus keeping them from fulfilling both the responsibilities. In the beginning, Mandela did not put his pupil over his family, but it was only later he realized that in order to be there for his pupil, he was compromising his duties towards his own family. Let us come to the next paragraph now. Further, he says that I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free, free in every way that I could know. I was free to run in the fields near my mother's hut. I was free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village. I was free to roast mealies under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow-moving bulls. So he says that in all these places he exercised freedom. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, and that I began to hunger for it. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself, the transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased, and go where I chose. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family. That is the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. So here he says that he lived his childhood like any normal child in South Africa. He only had to follow the rules which were being set up by his father or the customs of his tribe. But when he grew up and he began to learn the fact as how people of color, different colors, are treated, then he decided to stand against it. He had this urge for freedom from inside, earlier just for himself when he was staying out at night, and later for having a basic life, not just for himself but for everyone. Then he says, in Johannesburg, they had to struggle for having a peaceful marriage, family and basic amenities which everyone has to access to where law and order exists. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, that was taken away, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life, that transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, that drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal, that turned a family-loving husband into a man without home, that forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is indivisible. The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. The chains on all of my people were the chains on me. So further, Mandela says that he joined the African National Congress when he realized that it was not only he from whom the basic rights were taken away, but of all those who looked like him. He had a fire inside him, and that was to free his people from the injustice. And this fire changed the author completely as a man, from being scared to braver, a lawyer to the one breaking the law, a family man . It was the knowledge that he and his people have restricted freedom that made him into a selfless man as opposed to before. According to him, he says that freedom cannot be divided, and taking it away from someone was equivalent to taking it away from everyone, and that means taking it away from the author. Now, next paragraph. I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. I am not truly free. I am taking away someone else's freedom just as surely
as I am not free where my freedom is taken from me, the oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. He mentions that the need to free the oppressor is as high as that of the oppressed, because the oppressor is bounded by the shackles of hatred. He has the weight of all the people who he has tormented, for he carries the curses of all of their families. For taking away someone else's freedom and making them a prisoner, he became a prisoner of baseness. Thus, he is robbed of his humanity and needs to be freed. So, students, what we have seen in this tutorial is about the two responsibilities that every human has, and how, in order to fulfill his obligation towards the society, his obligation towards his family is neglected. He became a man of pupil when he realized that the idea of freedom was an illusion for him and people like him. Due to this thought, he joined the African National Congress and fought for his rights till he became the first black president of the nation, South Africa. According to him, the oppressor is as much a prisoner as the oppressed. As soon as the former robs the oppressed of their freedom, he himself gets robbed of his humanity. Thus, the oppressor too is not free. So students, we have seen that Mandela's hunger for freedom has changed his life. How? Once Mandela realized his hunger for freedom, his life changed forever. This transformed him from a family man to a man of his pupil, and a frightened young man into a bold one. He built his entire life around fighting for the basic fundamental rights for his community. He was more selfless and virtuous than ever. So, dear students, here the chapter ends. Whatever doubts and queries you have, that will be sorting it out in the Zoom session. Till then, goodbye. Have a good day, all of you.